ओके स्टूडेंट, सो वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन। सो इन कंटिन्यूएशन टू आवर लास्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम द चैप्टर मोशन इन वन डायमेंशन, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मोशन इन वन डायमेंशन एंड देन वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ग्राफ प्लॉटेड बिटवीन डिस्प्लेसमेंट वर्सेस टाइम, वेलोसिटी वर्सेस टाइम एंड एक्सेलरेशन वर्सेस टाइम। नाउ इन आवर लास्ट यूनिट 3 फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू डिस्कस इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। So basically the equation of motion correlates the if a body is moving with any initial velocity u and after time t it gains a velocity v and of course it will have some acceleration and it covers a displacement say s, then the first equation of motion is v is equal to u plus at. The second equation of motion is s is equal to ut plus half at square, and the third equation of motion is v square is equal to u square plus 2a. So in this unit we will basically learn how to derive these three equation of motion graphically, because from examination point of view the question asks that derive the first equation of motion or second or third equation of motion graphically, or numerical based questions are also asked from this equation. So for deriving these three equations you need to draw a graph between velocity versus time in which, let us consider a body when you have observed it was already having some velocity, say it was u at time t is equal to 0, then after some time say t its velocity becomes v meter per second. Its velocity becomes v meter per second. So the body starts from A, let this is B. Let this is the graph. Now if we have to derive the first equation of motion, that is v is equal to u plus at. So how to go for it? See, the first equation is relating the velocity, final velocity at end, and it is relating v, u, a and c. So acceleration is here. So we know that if we need to calculate the acceleration from vt graph, we need to find out the slope. We need to find out the slope of the graph. So if we need to find out the slope of the graph, you do one thing. The slope of ab can be found out like this. You draw a parallel line to x-axis from a and extend it up to a line joining from b to x-axis and name it c. Let this is b and let this is e. So if this is C, then this will be also C. Now this is BD is V, CD is U, so BC will be equal to V minus U. V minus U. Now for first equation of motion, the slope of AB will be equal to BC upon AC. BC upon AC. So this will be, and now slope of AB will give you the acceleration. So A is equal to BC is V minus U upon AC is T. Now do the cross multiplication, you will get AT is equal to V minus U, or transfer V is equal to U plus AT. So this is our first equation of motion. If we have to derive our first equation of motion, or for basically deriving all the three equations of motion, first we have to plot a graph between velocity versus time, where we have to consider the body was already moving with a velocity u and after time t it gains a velocity v. Then we will find the slope of the graph, and this is how by transposing we will get v is equal to u plus at. Now for second one, for second equation of motion, that is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Now you can see here this is displacement. Now displacement, how to get the displacement covered by the body from vt graph? By finding the area enclosed by the graph. So for finding the area enclosed by the graph, you will have this area. So basically if you observe, this is a trapezium. So we will find the area by dividing it into two parts. a area of triangle ABC and a rectangle ACDE. So for second equation of motion, area of graph will be equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of rectangle ACDE. Now the area of graph will be the displacement. Already we have used the symbol S to denote it. So S is equal to area of triangle ABC. It means half of base into height. So half of AC into BC plus area of rectangle length into breadth. So AC into CD. Now S is equal to half of what is base here AC, T, into what is BC, B minus U plus AC is T into CD is U. If this is U, this is also U. So we got S is equal to half of T into, now see from first equation of motion V is equal to U plus AT. We will get from here V minus U is equal to AT. V, U transfer on left hand side, we will get V minus U is equal to AT. So substitute here in case of V minus U, we will get half of T into T plus rearrange T into U can be written as UT. So this will be S is equal to UT plus half and T into T. This will be AT. So T into T, T square. So we will get S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So this is the second equation of motion. Similarly, if we have to derive the third equation of motion, that is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. If I have to derive the third equation of motion, then I will again find the area of this graph by finding the area of this trapezium. So area of graph is equal to area of trapezium ABCDE. Now we all know that the area of trapezium is half of sum of parallel sides multiplied by height. So here the sum of parallel sides. So parallel sides are AE and BD and height is ED. So this is T. So area of graph will be S. So S is equal to half of sum of parallel sides, that is AE plus BD multiplied by height, that is ED. So S is equal to half of AE is U plus, AE is U plus BD, that is BD is V multiplied by height is T. So if on rearranging, half of U plus V can be written as V plus U multiplied by, again you come back to here, V is equal to U plus AT. So V minus U is equal to AT. So T is equal to V minus U upon A. T is equal to V from first equation of motion. Substitute the value of T here, you will get V minus U upon A. Now transfer 2 and A on the left hand side, you will get 2AS is equal to V plus U multiplied by V minus U. Now if you observe the right hand side, it is written A plus B into A minus B. So we know that A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. So we will get B square minus B square. This implies on rearranging, we will get V square minus U square is equal to 2AS, or V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. So this is our third equation of motion. So in this unit, basically, we have to only discuss the three equations of motion, which are applicable only when the body is giving uniform acceleration. The very first thing here, the A, uniform, it is not variable. And then how to derive the three equations of motion graphically, and then we will have in our exercises and from examination point of view numerical based on these three equations of motion. For example, we can have a practice of some examples, some numericals based on these equations. See, one of the examples from your practice problem is a motorbike running at 5 meters per second. A motorbike running, it means when we have observed, see, while solving the numerical, let us discuss two things. Whenever we have a numerical, wherever it is mentioned, a body is starting from rest. If a body is starting from rest, u is equal to 0. And if a body stops, finally comes to rest, then v is equal to 0. It means if a body is starting from rest, initial velocity is 0. If a body comes to rest, final velocity is 0. So these two things you have to remember. Then we can go ahead with the numerical. A racing car initially at rest. So initially at rest is v is equal to 0. Picks up a velocity of 180 km per hour. It means the final velocity is 180 km per hour. In 4.5 seconds, so t is given 4.5 seconds. So calculate acceleration. So you have to calculate the acceleration. Second one, distance covered. So what is your distance covered by the body? Now you can see whenever we solve a numerical, the values given must be in the same system of units. It means either they are in MCS or they are in CGS. So you can see the time is given in SI unit. The velocity also must be in SI unit. So it is in kilometer per hour, so we will first convert into meter per second. So for converting, 180 multiplied by 5 by 18, so it will be 50 meter per second. So it picks up a velocity of 50 meter per second in 4.5 seconds. Now we can go ahead. The first part is asking what is A. So we know that from first equation of motion, A is equal to V minus U upon T. So final velocity 50 minus 0 upon 4.5. This is equal to 50 upon 4.5. Remove the decimal, 500. So 5 9s are 45, 5 10s are 50. So acceleration is coming 100 upon 9 meter per second square. In decimal, it will come 11.11 something. Second part, find the displacement. Now he is asking what is the displacement. So for that we can use either second equation of motion, that is ut plus r2t square, or third equation of motion. So we know that s is equal to ut plus half at square. U is 0 given, t is given, a we have already calculated. So s is equal to u is 0, so this part will become 0 plus half multiplied by acceleration is 100 upon 9 multiplied by 4.5 into 4.5. So 250 times it will go, and 9 is 0.5. On multiplying, you will get s is equal to 112.5 meters. So this is how to approach a numerical. So whenever, first thing, whenever you read a numerical, first note down all the information, then also write down what you have to calculate. Then imagine, think about the formula in which we can find the unknown quantities, or to find that quantity, what more quantities are related. Like in to find S, we need A. So first we have calculated A by using first equation of motion, and then by using second equation of motion, we have calculated S. And then if a body starts from rest, U is 0. If a body comes to rest, V is 0. If a body moves with a constant velocity, then A is 0. That is, acceleration is 0. This is how we will approach the numerical, based on equation of motion. For practice, we have number of problems given in your book, in the exercise. You can go ahead, solve the questions. For any doubt or clearance, you can take the help of solve exam. So that was all for today. Again, we will meet on our next session. So thank you.